Good morning, students. How are you all? Students of 5 Oak, how was your PT2 exam? Tell me first. How was your PT2 exam, students? Tell me. Hope it was good. Prarthana, it was nice. Okay. Abhik, very good morning. Archishman. Yes, Shivam, I am fine. Thank you. Chandralekha, Archishman. Okay. So, students, from today we will start the term to syllabus. Okay. So, get ready with your book. Today we will start a new story, The Little Bully. Page number 135. Get ready. Get ready. Page number 135. We will start a new story, The Little Bully. Can I start? Are you ready, students? Okay. So, Little Bully. Once upon a time, not so very long ago, there was a small boy called Hari. Although he was not very big, he was strong and he loved to tease all the boys and girls who went to school with him. That means, once a little boy named Hari who used to go to school, and he used to, though he was very small, but he was very strong and he loved, and you know, he used to tease all the boys and girls. What he loved to do most was to pinch. He could make a big bruise. Bruise means scar, wound, okay? A big bruise appeared in half a second. And you know, he loved to pinch others. And you know, he used to pinch so hard that within half a second, a bruise can appear. Another trick he played was pricking people with a pin. He used to prick with pin also. That was also very bad thing. That was terrible thing. No one should carry a pin to prick others, isn't it? Okay. So, you can guess how all the children hated him. They tried pinching him back, but that was no good because he could always pinch harder. They did not like telling their teacher because that was telling tales. It so happened that the class went for a picnic to the seaside for a whole day. All the children were most excited. And you know, you can guess, as he used to pinch other students, used to prick, used to tease others, that's why all his classmates hated him. Okay? They didn't like him. And once the whole class went for a picnic, and all the students were very excited, but they didn't like Hari. Okay. Next page. On that day, the sun shone bright and all the children were wild with excitement. They crowded into the train and sat down, but nobody wanted to sit next to Hari because he always pinched. And you know, it was a bright sunny day. All the students were so happy. They were wild with excitement. They crowded in the train. They sat down, but no one was ready to sit next to Hari. When they arrived at the seaside, out jumped all the children with a shout of joy. Down to the sands they raced, hand in hand, but nobody took Hari's hand. Nobody went near him. So as they arrived at the seaside, they jumped down from the train. They shouted in joy. Down to the sands they started racing hand in hand, but no one took Hari's hand. That means no one was ready to include Hari into their group. Hari was angry. He went to a sandy corner near a rocky pool and sat down by himself. He took out his lunch and looked at it. It was a good lunch. Okay, and it was a good lunch. There were two hard-boiled eggs, 6 jam sandwiches, 3 pieces of bread and butter, a ginger cake and a bar of chocolate. He would eat it all by himself. He would not offer anything to anyone. So, what happened? So, as all the students arrived at the seaside, they jumped down from the train, they were racing, they were playing, they were happy, but no one included Hari in their group. So, Hari was angry. Why did they avoid Hari? Because Hari pinched them. Okay. So Harry was angry. So he went to a sandy corner near a rocky pool and he sat down there. Then he opened his lunch box and it was a very good lunch. The lunch box was full of different types of foods. For example, the lunch box had 2 hard-boiled eggs, 6 jam sandwiches, 3 pieces of bread and butter, a ginger cake and a bar of chocolate. That means delicious foods, isn't it? And you know, in school, in the class, or during picnic, students used to share their lunch, their food with friends. But Harry was very much selfish. Okay, no one liked him. That's why it was his nature. He would not offer anything to anyone because he was not friendly at all. He was very selfish and naughty. So he sat there to have his lunch. Now come to the next page. Just as he was beginning on the eggs, he heard a hoarse voice near him. "Good morning. I am so pleased to meet a boy like you." Harry turned around and stared in fright. Fright means frightened, fear. "Whatever do you think he saw?" So just as he started his food, you know, he just started with eggs. Suddenly, wait. Let me ask a question. He heard a hoarse voice, you know. Someone wished him good morning and told that he was so pleased to meet a boy like Harry. So Harry was surprised. He turned around and you know what he saw. He was frightened to see that. And what was that? "Yes," Abhik answered me, "a giant crab." Harry saw a monster crab walking sideways out of the pool. His eyes were on the ends of short stalks and he looked most queer. He held out his front claw to Harry. Harry put out his hand to shake the crab's claw, but to his surprise and anger, the crab opened his pincers and nipped his hand so hard that the little boy yelled. So what happened? As Harry heard the hoarse voice, as he turned around, he saw a large monster crab, okay, and it was looking so odd, it was looking frightful. Then the crab, okay, then the crab, what the crab did, and the crab held out his front claw to Harry. Why? Whenever we meet someone, we wish him and also we do shake hands, isn't it? So as the monster crab held out his hand, Harry also did the same thing. And you know, to his surprise, that the monster crab did? It opened his pincers. Pincers, you know, we have hands, but the crabs have pincers, okay? And nipped his hand so hard that the little boy yelled. Yelled means cried in pain. Okay. What happened, Shagnik? Students, any problem? Shagnik, ma'am, I don't see the join call. But you are already joined here. What happened? Students, do you face any problem? Send me your answer. Okay, so then Shagnik, better disconnect and rejoin. Queer is odd looking, okay? Abhik, understood? Then yelled means cried, cried out in pain. So then the monster crab, okay, nipped his hand so hard that he cried in pain. He cried out, that is yelled. "Ah, here is my good cousin," said the crab pleasantly. And to Harry's horror, he saw a large sandy lobster crawling heavily out of the pool before the little boy. Shomili Bhattacharya, switch up. Yes. Heavily out of the pool before the little boy could stop him, the lobster took his hand in his great pincer-like claws and pinched it so hard that Hari yelled in pain. Then, who is saying, Archishman, but I am in great view. No, Archishman, here it is great view. What are you saying? Yes, it is in great view. Archishman, please disconnect and rejoin. Abhik, maybe you are facing the same problem. Disconnect and rejoin. So, then came a large lobster, and that was his cousin, okay. And the crab, the monster crab, became so happy. Then he said, oh, here is my good cousin. And you know, the big lobster also did the same thing with Hari. That what the monster crab did, the lobster did the same thing. What did the lobster do? The lobster, it also came out of the pool, and then it also took Hari's hand in his great pincer like claws and pinched it so hard that Hari yelled in pain. Again Hari cried out in pain. Next page. Then he stared at the pool in surprise, for out came sandy colored shrimps and prawns, more crabs and another large lobster, and they pricked Hari till he was soon black and blue with their pincing. And you know, then one by one another creatures were coming. Who were coming? Sandy colored shrimps, prawns, that means small small size. Archishman, switch up please. So more crabs, prawns, shrimps were coming out, lobsters were coming out, and they started pricking Hari till he was soon black and blue. Black and blue means his body is full of wounds, okay. They pricked him so hard. Don't you like it? Said all the creatures in surprise. Why? We were told you would love to see us because you are a champion pincher and pricker yourself. Come, join in the fun. And they, when Hari was cried, Hari was crying, he cried, when he crying out, then they said, why you didn't like that? We already heard that you are a champion pincher and you are a pricker and you love to do that. So we thought you will also love it. Hari leaped to his feet, crying loudly. His lunch rolled into the pool, and when the crabs and lobsters saw it, they ran to it and began to feast eagerly. Hari saw that they had forgotten him for a time, and he turned and ran for his life, tears streaming down his cheeks. So Hari leaped to his feet. Now Hari couldn't bear that pain, that much of pain. So as he leaped to his feet, his lunchbox fell on the sand, and his foods were lying on the sand. And as the crabs, the shrimps, the prawns, they saw the food, they were after the lunch. And as they were busy with the lunchbox with the food, Hari do? Hari escaped. Hari ran for his life. Okay, and he was crying so hard. He was crying too much. Tears streaming down his cheeks. They only did to me what I keep doing to the other children, he thought. But how it hurt, and how I hated those crabs and lobsters. I suppose the other children hate me too. Well, I jolly well shan't pinch or prick anymore. Then Hari realized that what he did. Jolly, usually jolly means happy, you know, means intention. Here, I jolly well, that means intentionally, okay, he is taking a oath, you know, he did promise to himself. And, Hari realized that what he did to other boys and girls, The lobsters, the shrimps, the creatures did the same thing to him, and now he hated those creatures. That means whenever he pinched and pricked other boys and girls, those boys and girls also hated Hari that much. Then Hari realized that what blunder he did, what wrong thing he did, okay. Then he realized that he did very bad thing to his classmates, to the boys and girls. And from then, from that day, he promised to himself that he would not, in future he will not prick, he will not pinch others, because that gives so much pain, that hurts so much, okay. Now he will be a good boy and he will not prick others. He took an oath that he will not pinch or prick anymore. Understood? That is the lesson of the story. And you know, students, from this story we also learned that we should not pinch, we should not tease others, we should not prick others. Rather, we will be helpful to our friends, isn't it? We should share our food, we should be helpful, we should help our friends, we should not give them pain, we should not hurt others. This is the lesson we got, isn't it? Understood, students? How was that story? How was the story? Did you enjoy this? So, students, today up to this, in the next class, we will continue the exercise part. Okay. So, till then, bye students. Bye bye. Bye students. Bye bye.